Welcome to FixSleep Bedtime Stories Channel, your sanctuary for relaxation, meditation, and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this journey to relaxation. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our magical sleep stories. So, let the tale begin. Calypso's Lost Necklace. Chapter 1. The Call of the Sea. In the historic harbor town of Bridgetown, where ancient tales of the sea were as plentiful as the salt in the air, a story was rekindled, the legend of Calypso's lost necklace. This artifact, rumored to be crafted by the sea goddess herself, was adorned with gems that mirrored the depths of the ocean. It was said to be lost in a storm that also claimed Calypso's favorite ship, disappearing into the annals of maritime lore. Into this world of myths and legends stepped Captain Elena Maris, a renowned sailor whose name was synonymous with daring sea voyages and a deep respect for oceanic folklore. With raven-black hair that flowed like the tides and eyes as blue as the Caribbean waters, she embodied the spirit of the sea. Captain Maris was captivated by the tale of Calypso's necklace and resolved to uncover its truth. Her ship, the Neptune's Whisper, was a magnificent vessel, sleek and sturdy, with sails as white as foam. The crew, a diverse group of seasoned sailors and young adventurers, shared Captain Maris's passion for the sea and its mysteries. Among them were Luca, the sharp-eyed navigator who could read the stars like a book, Tia, the spirited bosun with a knack for ancient sea shanties, and old Benjamin, the grizzled quartermaster with tales of the sea that could chill the bone. As they prepared to set sail from Bridgetown, the air was thick with excitement and anticipation. The crew busied themselves with preparations, loading supplies, checking rigging, and ensuring the ship was seaworthy for the journey ahead. Captain Maris, meanwhile, pored over ancient maps and texts in her cabin, piecing together clues that would guide them in their quest. Their first lead took them to an old fisherman, Old Man Calhoun, who claimed to have seen a strange light beneath the waves on stormy nights near the Siren's Reef, a treacherous area known for its unpredictable waters and hidden shoals. It was there, he believed, that the entrance to an underwater cave system lay hidden, a system that might hold the key to finding Calypso's necklace. As the Neptune's Whisper set sail, the crew felt the familiar thrill of embarking on a new adventure. The sea was in their blood, and the call of the unknown was irresistible. Captain Maris stood at the helm, her gaze fixed on the horizon, a mix of determination and curiosity in her eyes. Their journey to Siren's Reef was not without peril. The Caribbean Sea, beautiful yet unpredictable, tested their skills and resolve. They faced squalls that appeared out of nowhere, sending the ship rocking and rolling on the waves. Luca's expertise at the helm and Tia's quick thinking kept them safe and on course. Upon reaching Siren's Reef, the crew was greeted by the sight of tumultuous waters crashing against jagged rocks, a reminder of the many ships that had met their end in these treacherous waters. Captain Maris, undaunted, ordered the crew to anchor at a safe distance. They would have to approach the reef by rowboat to explore the rumored entrance to the caves. Armed with lanterns and ropes, Captain Maris led a small party, including Luca and Tia, towards the reef. The sound of the sea against the rocks was like the siren's song, both beautiful and menacing. As they navigated the choppy waters, they came upon what appeared to be an opening in the cliff face, partially hidden by the swirling foam. The cave entrance was narrow, and the sound of the water echoed ominously as they made their way inside. The walls were lined with luminescent coral, casting an eerie glow on their surroundings. They found themselves in a network of underwater caves, a labyrinth and world untouched by time. As they explored the caves, they discovered ancient carvings on the walls, symbols and depictions of Calypso, the sea, and what appeared to be a map of the caves themselves. It was a puzzle that beckoned to be solved, a guide to the resting place of the necklace. Their journey through the caves was fraught with challenges. They had to navigate through narrow passageways, some barely wide enough to pass through, and underwater chambers that tested their diving skills. The deeper they went, the more they felt the weight of the ocean above them, a constant reminder of the dangers they faced. As chapter draws to a close, Captain Maris and her team find themselves in a grand underwater chamber, its center dominated by a statue of Calypso, the sea goddess, her arms outstretched as if offering a blessing or a warning. At the base of the statue, partially buried in the sand, is a chest, old, barnacle-encrusted, but with the unmistakable glint of jewels peeking through. Could this be the resting place of Calypso's lost necklace? The crew's excitement is palpable, but so is the sense of foreboding. The legend of the necklace spoke of its beauty, but also of its power and the curse it carried. As they prepare to open the chest, they know that their adventure has only just begun, and that the true mystery of Calypso's necklace awaits them in the depths of the sea. Chapter 2: Secrets Beneath the Waves. In the grand underwater chamber, Captain Elena Maris and her crew stood before the chest at the base of Calypso's statue. The anticipation was palpable as Maris carefully opened the chest, revealing not the fabled necklace but an intricate map made of a strange, almost ethereal material and a series of puzzling artifacts, coins from ancient civilizations, a compass that pointed in seemingly random directions, and a cryptic journal with pages that appeared to change their content. Realizing the chest's contents were clues rather than the treasure itself, Maris led her team back to the Neptune's Whisper. Once aboard, the crew gathered around, their eyes fixed on the mysterious map. Luca, with his keen navigational skills, noted that the map seemed to chart not just geographical locations but also celestial alignments, suggesting that the necklace's location was tied to specific astronomical events. The cryptic journal, believed to have belonged to a previous seeker of the necklace, spoke of trials and tribulations, of a journey that stretched to the farthest reaches of the Caribbean. It hinted at other locations, each holding a piece of the puzzle that would lead to the necklace. Driven by the clues, Captain Maris charted a course to their next destination, the Isle of Echoes, a place shrouded in fog and superstition, said to be haunted by the spirits of sailors lost at sea. As they neared the isle, a dense fog enveloped the ship, and an eerie silence fell. The crew, seasoned sailors though they were, couldn't shake off a sense of unease. Whispered voices seemed to echo through the fog, and ghostly apparitions appeared and vanished in the mist. On the isle, they found an ancient lighthouse, long abandoned, its light extinguished. Inside, they discovered another clue, a celestial astrolabe intricately designed, pointing them to a constellation known as the Sea Queen's Crown. But their quest was not without its dangers. Another ship, the Black Marauder, captained by the ruthless pirate, Captain Red-Eyed Roland, had been following them, intent on claiming Calypso's necklace for himself. Roland, a former ally turned adversary, was known for his cunning and brutality. The prospect of obtaining the necklace and its powers had drawn him into a deadly race with Maris. The confrontation came sooner than expected. As the Neptune's whisper left the Isle of Echoes, the Black Marauder ambushed them, cannons blazing. A fierce naval battle ensued, the roar of cannons and clash of steel echoing across the waters. Captain Maris, with her tactical acumen, outmaneuvered Roland's ship, leading her crew to board the Black Marauder. A ferocious battle broke out on the deck, Maris and Roland facing off in a duel that seemed to mirror their own tumultuous history. In the heat of the battle, Maris managed to disarm Roland and secure his surrender. With Roland's ship captured and his crew defeated, Maris obtained another piece of the puzzle, a golden sextant, its craftsmanship unlike anything they had seen. The Neptune's whisper continued its journey, the crew deciphering the clues from the celestial astrolabe and the golden sextant. Their path led them through uncharted waters, past islands whispered about in sailors' tales, each step bringing them closer to the necklace, but also deeper into the heart of the unknown. Their journey was not just a physical one, but a journey into the lore and history of the sea. The artifacts they collected along the way were more than mere objects. They were keys to understanding the ancient relationship between sailors and the sea, the respect and fear it commanded. As they traversed these mystical waters, they encountered wonders and dangers alike. They sailed through a sea of bioluminescent creatures that lit up the night like stars in the ocean, navigated waters where the compass spun wildly, defying explanation, and faced a tempest that seemed to be conjured from the depths of legend. Throughout their journey, the crew of the Neptune's whisper grew closer, their individual strengths complementing each other, forming a bond strengthened by the trials they faced. Tia's courage and quick wit, Luca's navigation skills, and Maris's leadership were the pillars that held the crew together. As chapter draws to a close, the Neptune's whisper approaches their next destination, the ruins of the sunken city, an ancient place said to be submerged by the sea's wrath. The city, according to legend, held the last clue to the location of Calypso's lost necklace. Captain Maris and her crew, ready for the challenges that awaited, looked ahead with determination. The mysteries of the sea were vast, but they knew that the key to unlocking them lay just beneath the waves, in the ruins of a past long forgotten but still whispering its secrets to those brave enough to listen. Chapter 3. Enchantment and Betrayal. As the Neptune's whisper glided through the Caribbean, its sails full of the gusty wind, Captain Elena Maris and her crew approached the ruins of the sunken city. The legendary city, submerged beneath the waves, was a testament to the sea's mysterious and unforgiving nature. According to the ancient lore, the city was the last known location of Calypso's lost necklace, a treasure that held more than just monetary value. It was imbued with the power of the sea itself. Diving into the depths, the crew explored the hauntingly beautiful ruins. Amidst the collapsed columns and statues, overgrown with coral and teeming with marine life, they discovered symbols and inscriptions that hinted at the necklace's location. But the deeper they explored, the more they realized that the necklace was not the only secret the sunken city held. As they deciphered the inscriptions, a tale of love and betrayal unfolded. The city, once a thriving port, had been cursed by Calypso after a betrayal by its king, who had promised her his heart in exchange for prosperity but had then spurned her for another. The necklace, a gift from the king to Calypso, was the embodiment of that broken promise, and it carried with it the wrath of the scorned sea goddess. The crew's quest took a dire turn when they were ambushed by a band of merfolk, guardians of the sunken city, who saw them as intruders and desecrators. The confrontation was tense, with Captain Maris and her crew fighting for their lives against these fierce and agile creatures of the deep. In the midst of the battle, a shocking revelation came to light. One of Captain Maris's own crew, a young sailor named Marcus, was a descendant of the sunken city's king. Marcus had joined the quest not for adventure or treasure, but to break the curse that had doomed his ancestral city and to reclaim the necklace as a means to appease Calypso's wrath. With Marcus's revelation, the tide of the battle turned. The merfolk, recognizing the bloodline of their former king, ceased their attack. In a parley with the crew, they explained that the necklace's power had been the city's heart and Calypso's fury its doom. To lift the curse, the necklace needed to be returned to Calypso with a descendant's heartfelt apology and renunciation of the betrayal. The task was daunting, for Calypso was a capricious and formidable goddess, her moods as changeable as the sea. But Marcus, determined to right the wrongs of his ancestor and free his lineage from the curse, decided to take on the task. Captain Maris, respecting his decision, agreed to accompany him to Calypso's realm, a mystical place hidden from the world of mortals. Their journey led them to the edge of the Bermuda Triangle, a place where reality and myth blurred. Navigating through treacherous waters, where strange phenomena defied explanation, they reached a whirlpool that served as a gateway to Calypso's realm. In this otherworldly place, where the sea and sky merged into an endless horizon, they found Calypso. The goddess, both beautiful and terrifying, listened to Marcus's plea. Moved by his courage and sincerity, Calypso agreed to lift the curse, but with a condition: the necklace's power would be bound to the sea, never again to be wielded by mortals. The crew returned to the mortal world, their mission accomplished, but with a bittersweet realization. The necklace, once an object of their quest, was now part of the sea's lore, a treasure that belonged to the depths. As chapter draws to a close, the Neptune's Whisper sails back to Bridgetown, its crew richer in experience and knowledge. They had delved into the mysteries of mythology, confronted the consequences of ancient betrayals, and faced the wrath of a goddess. The legend of Calypso's lost necklace had been unraveled, but in its place, new legends were born, tales of Captain Elena Maris and her brave crew, who had journeyed to the heart of the sea and returned to tell the tale. Chapter 4. The Heart of the Ocean. As the Neptune's Whisper sailed away from the realm of Calypso, Captain Elena Maris and her crew found themselves reflecting on their extraordinary journey. they had ventured into the unknown, faced the wrath of a goddess, and witnessed the power of an ancient curse being lifted. The journey had changed them, forging bonds that would last a lifetime and leaving them with tales that would become legend. But their adventure was far from over. Word of their quest had spread across the Caribbean, attracting the attention of both admirers and adversaries. Among their foes was the infamous pirate, Captain Blackthorn, a ruthless marauder who had been following their trail, intent on seizing the necklace for himself. Captain Blackthorn, commanding the fearsome ship, the Nightshade, ambushed the Neptune's Whisper near the treacherous waters of the Devil's Backbone. A fierce naval battle ensued, with cannon fire echoing across the sea and the clash of steel ringing in the air. The crew of the Neptune's Whisper, battle-hardened and united by their shared experiences, fought valiantly against Blackthorn's onslaught. Amidst the chaos, Captain Maris displayed her exceptional leadership and combat skills. She dueled with Blackthorn on the deck of the Nightshade, her sword flashing in the Caribbean sun. The duel was intense, a clash of two formidable pirates, each fighting for their own cause. As the battle raged, a sudden tempest arose, as if summoned by the fury of the combatants. The sea roared, and the sky darkened, adding to the tumult of the fight. It was then that Captain Maris made a daring move. She outmaneuvered Blackthorn, disarming him and forcing him to surrender. With Blackthorn defeated and his crew subdued, Captain Maris faced a critical decision. She could claim the Nightshade and expand her dominion over the seas, or she could show mercy and let Blackthorn and his crew go. In a moment that defined her not just as a pirate but as a leader of honor, she chose the latter, setting Blackthorn free but warning him against crossing paths with her again. The victory over Blackthorn solidified Captain Maris's reputation as one of the most respected and feared pirates in the Caribbean. Her name became synonymous with courage, cunning, and a sense of justice uncommon among pirates. As the Neptune's Whisper continued its journey, the crew celebrated their victory and the success of their quest. They had not only found Calypso's lost necklace, but had also played a part in an ancient prophecy, balancing the scales of a long-standing betrayal. Upon their return to Bridgetown, the crew was greeted with cheers and admiration. Tales of their adventure had preceded them, turning them into legends in their own right. The story of their confrontation with Calypso, their battle with Blackthorn, and their journey into the heart of the ocean became a part of Caribbean lore, inspiring songs and stories that would be told for generations. In the aftermath of their adventure, Captain Maris decided to retire the Neptune's Whisper, docking it in Bridgetown as a symbol of their journey. She opened the ship to the public, allowing all who were curious to walk its decks and learn about their voyage. As for the necklace, it remained a secret known only to the crew. They have returned it to the sea, as per Calypso's condition, ensuring that its power would not fall into the wrong hands. The sea, after all, was its true home, and there it would stay, hidden in the depths, a treasure of legend, its mystery preserved. The story concludes with Captain Maris looking out over the harbor, her heart at peace. She had traversed the boundary between myth and reality, faced gods and monsters, and emerged with a deeper understanding of the sea's mysteries. Her legacy was not just the treasures she had found, but the journey she had undertaken, a journey that echoed the eternal call of the sea, a call of adventure, mystery, and endless possibilities.